When you die, man will plant you as a flower in our garden. When the earth takes, she will force it to exchange. Gerberas, tulips, roses, and lilies. Look, see how the soil turns with such ease, trading new seeds for old memories. Now, you are not a man easily imagined as a flower. A tree, maybe, a mountain, the island, chips and stuffing for Christmas dinner, sombreros in the front room, Mumbai motorway scratched onto VHS and the hot snap of ginger biscuits and sweet tea. There are 61 of us, and counting, left to remember you, so imagine how rattled I was when I saw my own face in the photograph. Me, the practically estranged heir to the solitary lineage of boys. Men of houses I never really lived in, so I am awkward to be here. Undeserving to belong, and besides, this bedside is a different precipice for the two of us. Both uncomfortable being seen here, like this. There is too much fuss in a funeral, when we have too many years of catching up to do and not enough now left to listen, then you might not even be a flower. This is undelicate language, but you are wilting. Your brain eager as always to blossom, but your body beckons for bed rest and blue pills and blissful quiet. Bruising tender petals scattering as ivy drips spring rain, scattering purple pollen pox over thin, waxy, pinked skin, and you will be a rose, I think. Prickly and soft in equal measure, but full of colour regardless. And I will tell that garden all the stories that I kept to myself, hopeful for some reply on a kind breeze.